rush pick the Lee Sin. We pretty much know Meteos is not going to play that champion. Doesn't fit his style this season. Hasn't played it so far this year either. So Impulse absolutely hiding every champion they possibly can with his first pick. Yeah. It's always one of the two.
It's almost like the Thresh of junglers in a lot of ways. He'll be able to play a little bit of everything depending on the team comp, and he will fit everywhere as long as you're good at the champion, especially with Jarvan being taken down a small peg in this patch, losing the armor from his flag and only getting compensated with three base armor. Much weaker in the late game.
Definitely is. And the Zed unsurprisingly comes back in sneaky right away, goes for his Corki. No bot lane bans save for a Morgana away. And C9 say, yep, Corki's the one.
And we've talked a fair bit today about how the world of scrims can often influence the way we see LCS. And maybe there's scrim results where high is good on multiple champions, therefore people don't think the Zed ban is worthy on the LCS stage. That's, at this point, the only viable explanation I can come up with for not banning away high Zed.
Yeah.
But
it's like the Kiwi Kid Annie rule.
We see it once again. Yeah, it's true.
It's like we sit up here and we're like, this champion's so obvious. But like teams have obviously information that we do not. We'll see what happens here. Xiaowei Shao, I know he likes playing the Yasuo, though I don't really expect the one to come in here. Now it's the Leona Graves lineup here. Very aggressive bot lane for Apollo and Adrian.
Corki is still a pretty decent pick against Leona, just generally speaking in the lane. So once again, Impulse does appear to just kind of be picking stuff they want to play.
Yeah.
Adrian is coming off of a spectacular game on Leona where he was destroying Wild Turtle fight after fight, who, by the way, was on Corki. So
yeah.
He's got that,
keep that one going.
Good memory from the last time he was on stage. I do like the picks here from Impulse thus far.
And with Cloud9 still, for the most part, hiding their lanes, though no solos shown by Team Impulse, and Cloud9 will have free reign to counterpick their top lane, but they've got to show most of their comp here. The jungler, I expect it to be Vi based on just the trends of what Meteos has been playing and the rest of the bands so far here in the lineup.
Yeah.
And they got to show their support, I would guess.
I wonder.
Braum.
Yeah, they're going to save their top laner for a potential counterpick. Braum for elimination, matching tank for tank. Meteos just taking, in his opinion, what the best jungler left on the board still is. Mm-hmm. Jarvan taking down a peg, Nidalee away from him, therefore fall to Vi. Cloud9 used to do a lot of picking just based off of straight-up power picks, tier list in each role, and Vi would be right at the top of that jungle. Interestingly enough, Cloud9's tier 1 jungler was banned, which is why they want to make sure they get a counterpick in that lane.
All right, and here we go. Karthus comes in for the first time all year, to my knowledge. Xiaowei Shao, Karthus versus Zed. I mean, to be fair, it could be like Impact playing a top lane, but Kennen as well locked in. I don't want to assume at this point. Top Morgana showed up this season. I don't want to assume it's mid Karthus. Although Xiaowei Shao with Exhaust tells me it's mid Karthus.
Theoretically, they could flex that pick.
Mm-hmm.
Kennen is a viable mid laner, especially against someone like Zed. It makes it relatively difficult for Zed to combo down. It would be safer than the Karthus in the mid lane against Zed. Xiaowei Shao knows full well what he is doing, though. And they know what he's laning against. This also makes Balls' pick in the top lane a little bit more difficult to do. Boy, that is a lot of damage Impulse put into that team with those last two picks.
And they've got plenty of engage potential, and C9 wanting to split that up just a little bit and play somewhat safer. Lulu comes in as the top lane pick for Balls.
And how about that?
Well, we just saw Dyrus play this matchup and win it against Avalon as Lulu versus Kennen. It seems to be a recurring trend here where Lulu's going to win that lane or assume to do so based on the picks. Maybe he can keep Impact from doing much.
Yeah, and again, we see the Lulu matched up with the Corki, which is always a little bit odd to me. I love seeing Lulu with more auto-attack-focused carries in general, or big tanks that can benefit from the Wild Growth stickiness, none of which they have there, which kind of tells me Cloud9 is there for hoping for the roaming and laning power of that pick, more so than the inbuilt team synergy that Lulu can offer.
Yeah.
Very engaging and interesting pick and ban phase here.
Yeah, so a very big team fight competition for Team Impulse. Really interesting overall. Cloud9, unsurprisingly, about the rotations, about the split push. There are, I guess, a couple of little fun synergies I do like about this, where Lulu can ult the Zed when he goes in and get a knock-up for his ult. So you can't even flash away from Deathmark anymore. hard to coordinate, but
it's
I would love to see it.
Yeah.
I think that'd be fun. See that happens. But as the players load onto the Rift, start tweeting. Hashtag TIPWin, hashtag C9Win to at Elable Esports. We'll see how you guys think this game will go. And it's going to look pretty fun at the bottom corner of the screen as we get these teams loading up. The battle to stay in the top of the standings for C9. Team Impulse to prove that they belong at the top.
And obviously there's the big jungle matchup between Rush and Meteos in this matchup, Leona versus Vi. But so much of the attention now, because of the uniqueness of the picks, is Shao Xiao's Karthus mid.
Yeah.
Against Zed. Most likely it will be a farmed out lane, but I really want to see how Shao Xiao survives Zed, stops him from roaming, and how he can get in position in these teamfights.
Well, I'm very excited. Shao Xiao most recently has started to look very good for Team Impulse. And we'll see. Ah! 80 damage! Yeah.
Shao Wei Shao, the victor. Game's over.
He got 10 gamer points for dealing the first point of damage in the game. He's going hard.
On a serious note, though, these level ones this week in the NALCS are evolving.
Yeah.
We have seen in previous weeks these five-man bully invades to get deep wards for lane swap opportunities are mostly uncontested.
Mm-hmm.
The Winter Fox game showed the first variation. And we're honestly seeing a very similar play by Impulse here, yep, where they waited in an interior bush and was basically a 50-50 of which side is Cloud9 going to choose to try and get deep wards. And if Impulse would have picked properly, they could have gotten a kill. So teams this week in scrims in North America are introducing a certain level of risk to getting the deep wards.
Shao Xiao's his emotes. Though. He's just happy. The thing is, he's staying on the ward too. Like, even if they did guess the brush, it would be a 4v5.
That's all part of the plan.
He's just caught dancing when the team is actually fighting without him. You don't have a global ulti yet, Shao Wei Shao. It's level one. All right, so default lanes for Team Impulse, but a swap for Cloud9. Rush and Impact are going to get themselves as Gromp. And I don't believe any deep wards from Team Impulse saw C9's lane movements, but they do run Impact up there right away anyway.
Yeah, so Cloud9 will be getting their swap. Whether or not that was just guesswork.
Oh, ooh. C9, though, they did start on the greedy side of the map. And they did the blue buff first to, like, get that and leave. But they realized that looks like it's a very similar situation all the same. Actually, I wonder if they can get a 3-buff start out of this. Because Rush didn't get his own blue. And he left that side of the jungle.
It's true. But I don't feel like they're going to go for that. The fact that Rush is skipping blue buff is a very atypical start for Lee Sin. It's something that I hope we see more of in the future, only because the small camps give so much experience and gold. Sometimes it's actually smarter to leave that blue buff up. I wouldn't be too surprised if Rush ends up beating that blue buff to Shao Xiao around level 5.
Yeah.
And gives him an early one in the mid lane. I don't feel like Cloud9's going to be checking that sooner, unless they go for a 4-man dive and just kind of take it on the way.
Yeah. I think all the wards here in the South Jungle have timed out by now, so they cannot track Rush. They don't know what buff he's wearing. They don't know even where he is necessarily. And until they see him, they won't know his jungle path at all. Elimination has not gone down to that West Jungle. They assume that buff is gone.
Impact's got to be super careful in this lane. He's actually in a really bad place because the lane started shoving and then Cloud9 Elimination showed up. It will freeze against him, and they have not done a double jungle. There is actually a really big chance that Impact gets starved heavily out of experience in this early game because Cloud9 is doing the double jungle.
Yeah, but Impact is still was leeching some XP for now. Like, he's keeping up, and I would say is likely ahead of Ball slightly.
Yeah, he hit level 3, actually.
Yeah, so not the worst thing in the world. Impact, though, he will have to remain safe, but Braum, not the biggest bully. If you dodge the Q, he can't do anything to you anymore. And Impact just relying on his mechanics to get more XP than balls.
It's a dangerous game he's playing, but so far he's winning it. That's really key in the top lane.
Ah, Rush.
Yeah, what a
move after all.
I guess he just decided to delay it. With the Rangers Trailblazer, he's clearing much faster now, so it was just a slightly modified early jungle route, since Lee Sin's not that great at soloing blue buff at level 2.
Elimination does land the slow friendly on Impact.
There
he's getting some meaningful damage.
The more Elimination does that, though, the more vulnerable he becomes to a Lee Sin gank. Especially since Lee Sin can gank so well through the lane.
Well, for now, though, Adrian's showing himself in the bot lane, so they know it's not a 3-man gank, and just seems like Cloud9's comfortable playing that aggressively in this situation. Lemon does still hold some potions. He can always stand behind me back to a minion. I guess he just feels safe in this situation. Balls does finally come down to the bottom lane later than we normally see him. Multiple waves already got shoved into his turret.
True. But the CS and experience is actually fairly comparable throughout the game. Rush is level almost 5. Meteos is behind him because of the double jungle. So when all is said and done, Impulse comes out with a slight experience lead and mostly even gold lead from that early game, which to me puts the attention towards the team fights in this game, where I actually see Impulse being incredibly scary.
Oh, absolutely.
Because we think about the places the damage comes from and the way Cloud9 can mitigate that damage. Oftentimes, Karthus isn't that good against Janna's or Soraka's or things that can shield or heal during the Karthus ult. There is only one shielding champion on Cloud9 to temporarily mitigate the Karthus ult damage and no sustained heals. So even if Xiao Yi Xiao is to die at the start of one of these late game team fights, the damage spread he will get just from his ultimate alone could be enough to turn these tides. It will make team fighting very scary for Cloud9 down the stretch.
I agree. So it's down to their split pushing prowess. Sneaky in a fight with Impact, though. Gets stunned up, kind of loses that trade, but well, the crowd is 4-1 in favor of Cloud9.
That's not too surprising, depending.
Impulse trying to trap Balls, maybe.
Yeah, based on the fact that Cloud9's won 7 of their last 8.
Yeah.
They're trying to extend their winning streak to 5 games. Impulse, though, playing a very solid lane swap game early on. Mostly relying on Impact's ability to fend for himself and succeeding in it.
Yeah.
It gives Rush an advantage over Meteos, which in the farm jungle matchup, if a Lee Sin, who is a ganking jungler, can get ahead of the Vi, it ends up being extremely punishing if Rush plays this properly.
We'll see if Rush can make these plays happen. Right now, he is just staying in that eastern jungle on his strong side of the map. These turrets have not fallen yet. Looks like an extended freeze for Cloud9's duo lane, a general push for Team Impulse. And that bot lane turret is about to die for this one. So C9 really not getting a starving lead, and they're certainly not killing turrets any faster. This level 1 looks way better for Team Impulse.
Yeah, well, they'll...
Or the lane swap overall, sorry.
Yeah, they should be able to trade these turrets. In fact, if Impact isn't careful, he's going to get himself killed here. Because that turret's going to be going down, and he has the threat of being sandwiched.
Yeah, you're right. They froze until 7 minutes, then the fortification
buff. He might flash this Q. No.
All right. Impact's instincts are good enough, and you're right. This turret losing a lot of health, but they're one wave too slow here, and they're going to have to try for the next one. They should still get it in time, but it will let the first recall go to Apollo. He's back in base. He's got a BF sword. Yeah. C9 still has to knock this turret down, then recall, then get to lane. There's a chance something good happens for Team Impulse as a result of them being a wave early.
Interesting. The TSM game didn't have first blood until 22 minutes. Something that may end up happening in this game if they continue this farm trading strategy. Especially since mid lane Karthus started tier.
Mm-hmm.
Xiao Yi Xiao is really playing the farm game. That's still such a mind-boggling pick here. He has to dodge pretty much every little bit of Zed's poke. Not even an all-in, because if he gets poked once or twice by the Zed, as we saw in the Zed versus Victor matchup, Zed will just take the shadow and all-in him.
Yeah.
So Xiao Yi Xiao playing remarkably well. Something about Impulse's solo lanes in this early game strategy, like we're saying they're out lane swapping Cloud9 a little bit, it's because their solo lanes are playing so darn well right now. They're in really dangerous 1v1s that are needing to maintain this game, and now they're going for high.
Look for high. Exhaust use the ulti in on a Xiao Wei Xiao, the trade on back. He's not going to outplay this at all. Xiao Wei Xiao gets first blood on high thanks to some friends.
Yeah, that was just a really clean gank, and now whoa, Kennen. Nope.
Barely even changed forms.
Yeah, I don't think that teleport. Oh, that was going to be because of the extended chase. They're going to go for this anyway, Freak.
Not looking good for Braum. Ulti comes in from Xiao Wei Xiao, and that's going to be his second kill as Sneaky falls as well. Outplayed,
oh,
Team Impulse.
This might be the road to a Team Impulse victory.
Yeah.
We know they're most likely stronger in team fights if they can stay grouped together. As long as Impact can get a little bit of farm, Xiaowei Xiao's Karthus may become unmanageable. If he gets to Rod of Ages and Zhonya's at some point, his item path kicks in so late into the game, but at the current pace, because he's 2-0, he could actually track that. Cloud9 might be in some big-time trouble here, Freaky.
Man, this is going to be so interesting. You think about mid laners that teams want to play, and it's like, well, you know, we can clear waves and then go roam and make plays and, you know, get our side lanes ahead. It's been a lane swap, so the lanes are longer. Two outer turrets are gone already. There's so much room to make plays with. Get out of the lane, get out of the lane, go make plays. Xiaowei Xiao can do that staying in lane. He can go assist those ganks. He can go make the Leona ganks even stronger.
Exactly. Bring the ganks to Xiaowei Xiao so that he can bring the pain to the rest of the map. It's surprisingly work. It's very hard to gank for a Karthus lane. The fact that Impulse was able to pull that off. Yes, they took two. But once again, that's because Impact has created such a distraction for the rest of the team while really not getting hyper-punished in comparison to balls. So much of the plays have been actually made by the 0-0-0 Kennen top this game.
That's true. He's done a good job pulling attention. 35 CS. He's got a lane pretty much frozen in front of him as well, which means balls can't stomach this lane much longer. He's got a ward in a river, so he might survive Lee Sin. In fact, they pinged the ward. They know that his ward went down there, so Rush has to look for an alternate gank path. Ball's playing with fire, though. Gets stunned. Impact goes in right now. Ooh. Nice Lulu open the stun. Is still going to land. In comes Rush.
Flash
Balls has flash. Rush waits. Kicks him just right in the face. 3-0 Team Impulse.
What a way to gank the Lulu right there. He has the boots advantage, so he is faster. Balls is out of mana, could not speed himself up. He doesn't play the game about waiting to dodge the Q with flash. He kicks him right in the face for the kill. Classic Lee Sin play. Great job.
The classic Lee Sin play of right-clicking on your opponent and then pressing R when you're in range.
Skill shots, who
takes notes, guys at home. Everyone could do that one. Just make sure you do enough damage. You don't kick him to safety. But Rush did the calculus. All is well. C9, though, they did get Dragon for the pressure top lane. So a kill for a Dragon, all said and done. Couple of waves of minions, though, also lost topside. Ball's TP was down, and Impact got to push that in.
They're doing to Balls right now what Meteos and Balls usually do to opponents. It's the return gank after burning the ultimate. If they get this wave under the turret, there's a chance they might just go for a dive. They don't have ultimates up, so they'd have to land a tremendous amount of poke.
Right. Balls uses 300 health so far. They really want this one. He's just hiding underneath. They're going to take the Q on in. Can enough be done? Balls, no ulti. Pushes Rush back, but Impact just secures the kill. Haunting guys first. A lot of damage.
Jeez. Not Balls' game. I thought for sure he was going to burn flash there and survive. After he had the turret aggro on Russian, they were on one side of the turret. Balls just flashes back, gives up the turret, but saves his life. This time, maybe he saves the turret for the death, but it just doesn't seem worth it. They're starting to have every member of Impulse get fed.
Wow, this is such a great early game. The aggression from Rush against T8, it failed miserably, started at 0-5. Against TSM, it worked a whole lot better. Against Cloud9, he's starting out 1-0-3. He's made every single kill happen, more or less instigating by himself and having follow-up by his teammates. This is the better side of the consistency, I guess.
We talked about Cloud9 in games they win, almost never dying. An average of 3.8 deaths in victory. Well, they are over that average right now, and they also haven't been very good at coming back in games that they haven't been able to control. I love what Rush has done in this early game. The early game pressure on Cloud9 to throw them off kilter puts them in a position where they have not been able to recover this split. If Impulse holds strong with the way they're currently playing, they're on a great path to victory.
Xiaowei Xiao taxes the little mini Bramblebacks.
May as well.
Taxing his jungle. Well, yeah, I guess. 152 minions before 14 minutes, and not a bad score at all. Elimination wanted to press this wave in, so the lane swap comes out. They want to actually keep Xiaowei Xiao down, maybe a little bit more. Use the duo lane of Cloud9 to put pressure there. Ball stays top, but they just give Hai the junk lane with a dead turret behind him in the 1v2.
Yeah.
This invade probably shouldn't even work. He's on the weak side of the map right now.
This is one of those instinct plays that Rush is trying to make, thinking he can get in.
W's up. Slowed. How'd he go?
Gosh. That one really hurts Cloud9 because they devote the resources to stop the counter jungling without actually stopping anything. Rush steals a red buff that he had no right in getting.
But such beautiful play by him. Looks like the farm-centric style from Meteos. He can't keep track of his own buffs nearly as much so far in game. And Rush's aggression has been really great to watch right here. The first pick, Lee Sin, a champion. We don't see much played anymore outside of Korea. We see some.
Even in Korea, it hasn't been a huge play with the power of Rek'Sai and Jarvan recently.
Yeah.
A lot of people just dropped the Lee Sin altogether for the more powerful champions. With Rek'Sai receiving some nerfs, Jarvan being taken down this patch, and a jungle ban on Nidalee, it's time for Lee Sin to make his return. Perfect for Rush. That's the champion he became rank one in Korean solo queue on. He is more than comfortable with these most recent patch changes.
Well, Cloud9, though, happy to keep the pressure on themselves. Mid lane loses two-thirds of its health. Quick little rotation by Cloud9. No minions lost really anywhere. High still bot side. Actually basically freezing the lane. Pushing out now, but he's well on his side of the map. Just securing farm for himself. One more good play, and Z9 take the outer mid turret down.
Yeah. I mean, it is kind of time to talk about what Cloud9 should do now to deal with this super-fed Karthus. And so much of this will hinge on Hai's ability to split push. Even though Impact was able to survive 1v2, he can't deal with a Zed split push. In fact, nobody on Impulse is actually capable of dealing with a Zed split push right now. So Meteos is hoping someone tries and the Cloud9 can get an advantage that way.
We'll see if that does happen here right now, though. Team Impulse able to hold their lanes pretty well. Meteos sticking with Hai to try to clear some wards out. They kill a pink. They are there we go. They have Lemon come in to replace that ward for their own side. Capturing that brush for a short time in the name of Cloud9. And Sneaky trying to outplay Xiao Wei Xiao, but gets slowed up. The exhaust actually used early. He thinks he can kill him. He's Valkyrie's out. Now Xiao Wei Xiao's out of mana. Maybe a bit aggressive.
Yeah. Well, he just wanted to exhaust him, so he had some free time to farm. Apparently what Xiao Wei Xiao is onto right now. He's actually sitting on 2,400 gold. He is trying to get the most out of this farm. It's putting the team in a little bit of a pressure hole right now. It's going to allow Cloud9 to bully around the map a little bit, knowing the exhaust is down on Xiao Wei Xiao. Whether they try and push mid or just set up Dragon. Looks like they're going for the mid lane push. Xiao Wei Xiao definitely sticking around too long.
It's going to be pretty risky, but Adrian shows up all the same. Blue buff on Xiao Wei Xiao means he will have mana soon. The engage comes out, not many knockups, and here comes Impact, plus the Requiem. This could be bad for Cloud9. Just the one for zero as they disengage.
Yeah, Requiem ends up not granting Impulse anything. But the fact that they didn't even need Xiao Wei Xiao for that gank speaks to some severe troubles on the Cloud9 front. There goes Rush!
Oh, nice kick back on elimination. Down he goes. 6-0 Team Impulse. Mid lane editor. It's actually going to go to the blue team as well. And so much is going right early game for Impulse.
Just a great display from Team Impulse thus far. Really punishing Cloud9 for their typically passive early games they have been playing lately. Rush able to make play after play here. 5 out of the 6 kills he has participated in, but he has been all over the jungle placing wards and setting up these plays. Him and Adrian together have been great.
And there's Dragon 1, there's Archangel Staff being finished for Xiao Wei Xiao, right in time to have even more ability power. Take the jungle, take every jungle, who cares? It's Karthus, give him the farm. 215 minions at 18 minutes, definitely a very fast clip for him. And you think about how this comp came together, right? Lee Sin cares more about ganking than farming, so yep. Give the jungle to Xiao Wei Xiao. Right, they roamed up Adrian up early on, get him a gank, put Zed down. So C9 trying to find a way back in. They have wards here. They can spot Rush and look for this play, but a quick ward hop means nothing is gained.
Yeah, can they even get the monster?
Yeah, they got big one. That's a glimmer of hope for Cloud9.
That's what's up. Yeah, I
60
mean,
gold.
You can already see Cloud9 trying to itemize a little bit defensively. Meteos having to go Aegis second item right after Warrior. I mean, the biggest problem here is the fact that Balls hasn't been able to become involved in this game as a Lulu player. Top lane Lulu is often used because you get scaling abilities on your utility. The giant shields, the large amount of move speed, and the extra picks damage on your auto attacks. But Balls is sitting on a gold total that would more be suited for a support. If we check the gold, Balls is at 4,300 gold. So is Adrian on the other side of the map.
Oh, wow.
Balls is a support Lulu right now, unless he's able to get a little bit more farm.
Yeah, definitely pretty far behind for himself. Second lowest on the team right now, if I got those numbers right. Meteos, though, is farming up a Storm himself. No kills or assists, but 88 minion kills. Kick him into the wall. Balls gets hit. He should have the ulti available. He's going to save it or just not even bother. There he goes. Pops it. Tries to get out of the range, but Adrian shows up, claims himself the kill. Highest kills in the team. 203.
I mean, it's equivalent to leaving a support alone in the lane. You can't do that with these this far behind. They're trying to split push desperately. And is Xiaoyi Xiao going to solo Corki?
Well, he's dodging some of the lay waste, but Defile. Clearly too much to deal with. Good solo key using the exhaust to make that happen. Sneaky summon is worth down in the prior mid lane fight, so maybe a bit lopsided, but still, all the same. Top lane tier 2 goes down. Mid lane solo kill for Xiaowei Xiao. Impulse not letting up whatsoever.
No, and they have no reason to. They also have the Karthus ultimate up yet again if a skirmish does break out. The one saving grace for Cloud9 during all of this is they did create some space to split push. The fact that they've been able to stay even in turrets 4-4 would be their only window to come back in this game.
And that's good by them. They have kept that pressure up, that 1-3-1, never really falling for C9, but Team Impulse, knowing that 1-3-1 is happening, applying pressure to the lanes where they think they can get some kills. The bot lane swapped back after the lane swap. Outer turret was dead, meaning they could go in and dive them behind the remains of a dead tier 1 turret. Well, that turned into a couple of kills thanks to Requiem. Jump onto the mid lane, just out of nowhere onto high, use exhaust, go right on in. Sure, that's going to work as well. Over and over, Impulse finding the right pressure points to attack.
I want to put this game into a bit more perspective, though, just for how good Cloud9 has been up until this game. Cloud9 started the year losing 3 out of 4, but since then, they won 7 out of 8 games. People on Cloud9 just simply weren't dying. The most deaths Sneaky has had in a game all year is 4 against Winterfox in week 4. He is already sitting at 0-3-0, 21 minutes into this game. This has been a destruction by Impulse. But Apollo, let's see if he can escape this. He absolutely can.
Yep. Nice little flash, dashes away. Zed did not want to go back to his own clone in case there may be some people around. And the nice record from Xiaowei Xiao to help the disengage. Team Impulse still unwilling to die pretty much anywhere. 269 at 22 minutes now for Karthus. Xiaowei Xiao still well above everyone else in this game. And his Seraph's Embrace already done 22 minutes in. But here comes some teammates. Leona and Vi around the corner. High's Shadow is down.
No ult.
Jumped on by Impact. There's the re-engagement. Zhonya stops the assault and battery. High's going to be an easy kill for Apollo with the backside. Now Meteos in a 1 versus 3 means it's a double kill for the Graves. 10-0 Team Impulse.
Team Impulse beginning to make a statement that they belong as a top-tier team in North America. 10 kills to 0, as you said, Freak, in this game. 6,000 gold lead. It's just about them now getting control of the objectives and continuing the pressure on these mid-tier turrets. At this point, Cloud9 is going to be just putting in some scatter tactics and making it as difficult as possible for Impulse to close out. Looking at that fight once again, Impact is just so on point this game.
Yep.
Stuns the Zed, stops the assault and battery, waits for the backup to arrive, and they quickly pick up 2 more kills. I also got to point out, we know what the 300 CS record is, I think. It's something around like 22 minutes in pro games. There's the argument between like whether that's in Challenger games or LCS games and what defines a big time game. But as far as this year, when jungle monster camps respawn slower, the fact that Xiaowei Xiao is going to hit 300 CS probably before 24 minutes, I'm willing to say is a record for this season since the jungle changes. He is farming at an absurd pace. He's going to get it right here.
All right, here we go.
Just get
him. Come on, do it. Apollo, tax this. He's like delaying it. He's baiting all of us. There it is.
Sub 24 minutes for 300 CS. With the slow respawns on the jungle time.
Yeah, that's true.
Remarkable.
Less wraiths to kill, less wolves to kill, but all the same, Dragon number 2 goes right away to Team Impulse now. They have held complete control. The only things on the board for Cloud9 were that first Dragon due to a top lane gank and then split push and keeping the turret scores equal, but they have yet to slay anyone on Team Impulse. And I feel like that only gets harder as time goes on.
Yeah, it really does. They're going to be completing double Zhonya's pretty soon as well. High hasn't been able to have much of an impact in this game on Zed. I mean, this is the one time in the consecutive games where High's played Zed where the team has actually proven that they know just how to deal with this.
Yep.
The split push hasn't been a huge factor. The mid lane was easily farmable by Xiao Wei Xiao. And the jungle pressure was honestly
crazy good.
Crazy, crazy good.
And to his credit, Hai has managed to equalize the turret score. I mean, it is strange to see a team ahead so much not have a turret lead as well.
True.
I mean, I suppose they've chosen to give up that turret to get their own pushes to happen, but the split push has been reasonably successful. C9 down 6k gold, a meaningful amount, to be fair. Not insurmountable, but a sizable lead for Team Impulse, all that said. Xiao Wei Xiao, 24 minutes in, had three completed, 3,000 gold items.
Yeah, this guy, and
Fork
he
elixir
picks up
too.
The elixir, which makes this point in the game so scary. Before death cap and before consuming his elixir, he's at 471 ability power. That Karthus is not messing around.
Yeah, the Rod of Ages, the Seraph's fully stacked, so those big power spikes are there. Now it's just gravy. It's like, yeah, get some Void Staff then, get some death cap AP. But now Hai is on the wrong side of the map. Will he get friends? He certainly can't dual Impact if he pops Zonias properly.
Impact, once again, is putting himself in a precarious situation with him thinking he can outplay. At this point, he's just splitting the minion waves, which is all he needs to hold Hai at bay while the rest of his team pushes.
Well, and push they shall. The shield's broken. No more shields for Cloud9 for about 30 seconds as that regenerates itself. Balls is pushing the top lane, but this four-man push mid is not getting anything done, and Balls is catching up right now. I was about to ask if you've seen a game where one soul laner has three times the farm of another since Xiao Wei Xiao's knocking on that versus Balls, but
I see.
Yeah.
But because Cloud9 is doing the 1-3-1 solo lanes on both sides, then support AD carry jungle in the middle, they're actually freezing this game quite well.
They are.
It was looking to be very out of hand, but in the last 5 minutes or so, Balls has really gotten himself back in the game with the side lane farm, and Hai is keeping Impact from making plays on the map. If Cloud9 can continue this for several more minutes, they'd be in a pretty good space. Great play there by Hai.
Impact doesn't even bother to Zonias. So he takes a couple hundred damage that maybe he didn't need to, but if he's not under any real threat, then maybe who cares? Hexdrinker, by the way, was bought by Hai here. He delays his last Whisper power spike, and facing double Zonias and Randwoods means it's kind of important.
And based on how long this 1-3-1 has been going on, Impulse actually kind of needs to make some decisions soon. They haven't been able to pull up a turret lead. The longer they split this farm in the side lanes, the lower their percentage gold lead becomes.
Yeah.
And their lead is actually shrinking because they're not able to expand it, if that makes any sense. So
it
actually means Impulse has to take at least some level of risk to continue their lead in this game.
Yeah, the incremental value of items is going to go down slowly over time. Most of your damage is kind of here in the offensive builds of Team Impulse. Most of the tank stats kind of there as well. Of course, you'll still grow, but the first two are the big ones.
Luckily, they have Karthus, who's one of the fastest Baron takers in the game.
And they have Lee Sin, who's one of the best at securing it as well. So Cloud9, good luck to you. Sneaky and mid high at bot. They're forced to walk over.
They took a lot of damage there, actually.
They did. And Team Impulse unwilling to take that risk. They're so far ahead. They don't want a 50-50 the smite, or even 60-40 the smite. And they're just going to recall on back. This gives a little bit of room for Cloud9 to do fun things.
Yep. When Lulu gets to that death cap, it becomes another threat again. He's actually about 200 gold shy of that.
Yeah, this wave should give him that money in the top lane. So you expect Balls to be fairly useful in the very near future. Level 13 on him, not too far behind Impact. Apollo sent to hold top for now. He's going to be going Last Whisper third, so that'll be a nice power spike, increasing his spell damage, furthering the burst potential of Team Impulse in the next 600 gold for that AD carry. Baron, though, still obviously the objective these teams care about. The advantage for Team Impulse, though, is that their split pusher has teleport. Hai does not. So the chance of making some big plays and using mobility to make a 5v4 lies with Impulse.
Wow, they're going right for the Baron. This is the play. Hai is not there. They're either forcing a smite steal or getting Baron. I wonder if Midos even tries this. I think they just give it up.
And he's going to go in and get it! C9 get Baron, Meteos goes in, but they've got to leave the team behind. I can't see C9 winning this battle, but it's high sticking bot. Balls TPs to the bot lane.
And now they do not have empowered recall. They don't have the recall to get back. This is an inhibitor for Cloud9.
And by the way, Corki just killed Kennen. Impact died trying to teleport bot lane. High and Balls are pushing the base. And by the way, C9 can track the rest of the team. They can stop the recalls. They've done so. Inhib is gone. Apollo recalling on a ward. Xiaowei. Xiao's got to run for his life.
Cloud9 made a lot of noise at Worlds playing like this in games they were down. It's one of the main reasons Hai got that reputation as a great shot caller, but it is the team who is making these plays, keeping the side lanes going once they realize they are down, eliminating deaths, and then forcing the enemy team into difficult decisions. A somewhat 50-50 Baron. Meteos did not get the smite, but so much damage went onto Baron. While Hai was making that split push pressure, it just accelerated the decision making and enhanced the chance of a mistake. I mean, looking at this. Jeez.
Meteos queued through it. It was already dead.
Yeah, everyone just tries to burst damage. Impact was trying to stun Meteos to prevent the jump in, therefore not having an impact on the fight itself. Sneaky finishes him off. Hai is gone. Lulu was so close to being interrupted with that. And they get that inhibitor. What a play by Cloud9. Really complicating matters for Team Impulse.
Complicates them indeed, but a bottom lane inhibitor being dead almost means Xiaowei Xiao has a nice lane to farm by himself. There's no Dragon and no Baron on the map for 5 minutes or so. So what can C9 get off of this Baron buff? There is a tier two in mid and top lane for them to contest.
I think C9 just gets time. Is more so. They already have the exposed Nexus turrets, basically.
Yeah.
An open inhibitor for the rest of the game once it respawns. And that continued amount of threat from the split pushing high. Impact, while he can kind of hold off the Zed, needs a lot more before he has a legitimate kill threat on Zed. When Impulse couldn't close the game with the advantage they had, after that kerfuffle, they are in severe danger of not being able to close this game at all.
That's true. Definitely a risk for them. They do still hold a 4,000 gold lead, though. They did go roughly equal in kills, but dropping a turret or so did, of course, put the gold a little bit back for C9. And as the Baron buff times out in the next few seconds, I wonder if you are back to square one. The inhibitor comes back before the Baron respawns. The inhibitor comes back, I think, before Dragon respawns, or close to it. Which means that before the next crazy fights erupt, the map, I would say, is in kind of equal standing. Aside from the fact that Hai, of course, can apply pressure to that one lane.
Yeah. No, I agree that the map is in miraculously equal standing. You don't think that in the 11 kill to 1 game.
Yeah, no.
It's a Cloud9 special. This is something they are able to do that most other teams cannot. It's their mastery of the side waves, even when behind.
I've seen this before. Impact learn.
There's a chance that Xiaowei Xiao could get a CS record this game if things keep going. 420 CS, only 33 minutes in. You have to wonder, though, when he's going to actually stop farming. Because...
yeah, he's almost out of slots.
Yeah, Death Cap is his next item, most likely. And then at that point, he's either selling his boots or needing to stop farming. And they're going to want Apollo to be max items before then as well.
Yeah.
But just with the way Cloud9's playing this game, yeah, I don't see a world where Xiaowei Xiao doesn't farm to 500 or 600 CS.
500, I think, for sure. 600, we'll see. Sneaky forced to jump away, Xiaowei Xiao. Pushing on in with the Wallopine. He is already level 18, by the way, 34 minutes in. Mid lane under fire. Now that Baron buff has timed out. Zed is bot against Impact, but Kennen, of course, has Teleport. And a ton of Magic Pen and even Distortion Boots, so a lot of TPs available.
Here's the big risk for Impulse, since they're not really able to force fights with Leona. I mean, I think that's the big thing the Team Impulse should be doing while Zed is split pushing, is going in hard with Leona, Alt, and Lee Sin to just make a play and punish Cloud9 for the split pushing, because as it is now, they're only opening up opportunities for Cloud9 to beat them. Since Impact is bottom as the teleporter, and Balls is top as the teleporter, there's only one team that can force 2v1s inside of a base. and that is Cloud9. If that happens, they're in risk of losing even more of their base and being down two inhibitors. The way Cloud9 wins this, Balls teleports in to help high, they kill Impact, Team Impulse collapses down, which then opens up an inhibitor for Sneaky on the other side. That's the way this split push game would work for Cloud9 in a winning world.
Well, we'll see if Fnatic can keep that winning world. Xiaoxiao posing as Neo in this game. Dodging away from Agent Sneaky. And we're going to see Hai in his favorite landmark in this game. You'd think he's playing Garen with his affinity for Brush this game, but that's what he's going to play next when they ban Zed.
Yeah.
They know Hai's Garen is too good.
I feel like Garen's split-pushing presence isn't quite as good as Zed's.
He regens so much, though.
He would regen heavily. There'd be no getting him out of there.
Well, Xiaoxiao starting to take some meaningful damage from the...
Cloud9 has stumped Team Impulse. Impulse does not know what to do against this. It's been the same script for the last 15 minutes. The first 7 minutes, Impulse was like, all right, we got to try something. Go for Baron. Didn't work.
Yeah.
Then created another 7 minutes of being stumped. And we're back at Baron again. Round two? Question mark? Or do they actually go for a fight?
I guess the thought is they are a team fighting team, and if you can only force team fights around objectives, you don't want to force team fights around turrets, then wait for the objectives to come back. They've kind of willingly not been too aggressive until they maybe get an out rotation. Meteos has to jump away. The knockback by Elimination means the turret's going to go down. The teleport by Balls is useless. He stays topside, which means he can maybe get his own tier 2 turret. Impulse forced to run.
But no kills. That's the critical thing. Cloud9 can give up a few of those. It's a small game right here. But everyone keeps escaping.
Here's the teleport. Impact is here. It's a 5v3. What can they get? Adrian low, but they've already picked up Corki. They're now onto Medius, who ults back in, but will not deal enough damage. 2 for 0, but the push continues.
Track this split push. Inhibitor going down again. Second inhibitor on the way from Cloud9. They are scattering.
So what now can happen off of the 5v3 on the map? Balls will get top inhib turret. Bottom inhib itself is gone. More turret kills did go to Cloud9, but with the 5v3 for 25 seconds, I feel like that should mean Baron.
You think that.
Meteos is dead, how do you not?
Yeah, I think they do it because they got high to recall at least this. Yeah, you're absolutely right about this being a very clear Baron opportunity for Impulse. But once again, it shows you how dynamic this game has become. 13-1 in Cloud9, making Impulse fight for every single thing.
All right, Adrian, be tanky, Balls.
Is he trying to steal with Goodlands? I don't know why Cloud9...
No! Balls goes down! There's more time now for Team Impulse to make the plays. Empowered recalls to get them out. High, being threatening.
That was an absolute overreach by Cloud9 right there.
Oh, they're on wards, though.
I feel like they were trying to steal with the Glitterlands, which is just overly optimistic from Balls.
Oh, no. Xiaoxiao?
I mean, he has Zonya.
Deathmark's on him, though. He can get some damage from the Shadow.
Yeah.
That's a bit painful.
It's all about delaying these recalls so the Cloud9 can secure Dragon.
That's really nice, though. Very heads-up play. Cloud9, again, so darn good at cross-map objectives. High now forced to run from Rush. Rush is tanky. High has no ult. There's Dragon 3. Kicks him over the wall. Lands it. Oh, no.
Hexdrinker?
Hexdrinker's not enough. No. Kills him through it. Death cap was already done for Xiaoxiao. He is massive.
1,016 ability power on that Karthus ultimate.
Oh, my God.
That's going to hurt right now. Baron buff is helping that. The Dragon buff is helping that. And his blue elixir is helping that.
Requiem deals 1,159 damage.
To everyone.
To everyone.
Yeah, that helps.
And the blue elixir debt, what, is like 40 true damage as well?
Yeah. One of the many reasons that Cloud9 has been avoiding team fights forever. And now with the Baron buff, this is what Impulse has been waiting to do. High getting a little too cute with his split pushing, finally getting caught out. If Impulse finds a fight here, the game would be over. They might actually force Cloud9. They're trying to end right now.
They're going to try right now. Adrian goes right in. It's going to be a big AoE explosion.
Over.
1 for 1. Down goes the Braum as well. Corki falls on top of that. That is an ace inside the base. Rush taking the turret. He doesn't care. 19-2 in kills. High, the final stand. Gets the jungler. Can't get much more. It's going to be a win. Team Impulse in consecutive games take down Team Solo Mid and now Cloud9.
And just like that, it's over. They spent a good 20 minutes chasing high around the side lanes. But the instant Cloud9 looked at Impulse right at him in an actual fight, it was just death for them. As soon as they killed high, they push in 5v4, and you really got to see the team fight superiority by Team Impulse as soon as they just got their mitts on Cloud9.
That was absolutely impressive. We asked if Team Impulse would be unable to deal with the split push, but it seemed like they were a kind of a step ahead in a way, where they said, yeah, split push in, overcommit, we'll come back at you, get the TP advantage, then flank, then force the team fight that Team Impulse wanted so badly. Two kills off that, clean up the waves, rush down Baron, use that to finally push.
Yep.
They were just waiting for those neutral objectives. You knew this team comp couldn't possibly lose a team fight around a neutral.
Yeah, they could only lose the neutral objective.
Which happened once.
Nearly costed them in this one, but you look at the kill score there at the end of the game, 19-3.
Yeah.
That's going to make Team Impulse very happy. And you look at
that. You look at that, it's like, wow!
Yeah.
I went 6-0-6 against Cloud9.
The gauntlet these guys are running in this part of the schedule is absurd. They beat TSM at the end of last week. They just beat Cloud9. And next up is Team Liquid, who's on a hot streak.
Yeah.
I mean, if they can go 3-0 in this stretch, the confidence that this will give Team Impulse going into the playoffs, you would, if they were able to do that, you would have to start considering them one of the best teams in North America and give them a very real shot in the playoffs.
Oh, absolutely. This team finally turned on in week 6. It took them more than half the split to get there, but I feel like they look like they're there. Team Impulse looks so good on paper. You had to assume all these players were going to perform well. It has finally come together after a month and a half.
I mean, it took a while. Impact, remember, it's not like he had the offseason to settle in.
Mm-mm.
He got here in week 2.
Yeah.
And it's been a process since then to integrate him into the team and get everyone comfortable with each other's play styles. Rush just started playing on teams that weren't solo queue at the start of this season. Like, these guys were so raw in their talent. Mm-hmm. But the teamwork is becoming a real thing, and we're seeing the results.
Yeah, it's very impressive watching Team Impulse play and improve throughout the split. Going to check in with Riv for a word.